Identifying correlation and causation. Answer the questions below. A researcher measured the shoe size and math ability of a large group of children. She found that having a larger shoe size does not indicate that a child has more or less math ability. What does her analysis show? Okay, usually because there's so many words going on in these questions, I just like to stop after the question, think about the question, decide what I think in my head, and then see which answer matches. So, it says a researcher measured the shoe size and math ability of a large group of children, okay? She found that having a bigger shoe size does not indicate if they're better or worse at math, so more or less math ability. So, shoe size doesn't impact, has no correlation with math ability because it doesn't show more or less. So to me, that tells me there's going to be no correlation. So now let's look at my answers. Number one says there is no correlation between shoe size and math ability. Well, so far, I'm liking the looks of this one, but let's keep going just to be sure. Number two says there is a correlation between shoe size and math ability. There may or may not be causation. Now, we know that correlation does not imply causation, but this says that there is correlated, which means the bigger the shoe, the better the math, or the bigger shoe, the worse the math, but that's not what this said, so this one's out. Finally, it says there is a correlation between shoe size and math ability. There's probably also causation. This is because there's likely an increase in math ability with an increase in shoe size. Well, since there wasn't an increase and an increase, this one's out, so it's got to be the first one. There's no correlation whatsoever because no matter your shoe size, it didn't impact whether they were good or bad at math. Okay? Let's look at number two. A grocery store collects sales data. It found that when customers buy less bread, they tend to purchase more rice. Okay? So less bread, as bread decreases, rice increases. So is there a relationship here? Yes, there is some correlation. So this one says there's no correlation. Well, that one's out because this one says that the less bread, there's more rice. So there's clearly something going on. Number two says there's a correlation between the amount of bread bought and the amount of rice purchased. However, there's no causation. This is because there is an increase in the amount of rice purchased with a decrease in the amount of bread bought. Okay? Let's just hang on to that one for a minute. Let's read number three. It says there is a correlation between amount of bread and amount of rice purchased. There may or may not be causation. Further studies would have to be done to determine this. Now, we don't know anything except when people buy less bread, they tend to buy more rice, okay? But if there's an increase in rice, there's a decrease in bread. If rice is on my x-axis, let's think about this. If my rice is x-axis and my bread is y-axis, what it's saying is with an increase in rice, so the farther we get along on our rice axis, the less bread there is. All that means is that there's going to be a negative correlation. So that tells me nothing about causation. So this one doesn't even make any sense. But we do know there may or may not be causation. We're not sure because we need to do more studies to find out more information. Number three, Tom compared the player statistics from his team's tennis season. He determined that being taller implies that a player has faster serves. So right now we're saying that the taller people have faster serves, and the shorter people have slower serves. What should he say based on his findings? Now, this word implies means that there's a relationship. So no correlation is not an option because we know there's something going on. Number two says there is a correlation between height and speed serve. There may or may not be causation. Further studies would have to be done to determine this. I like this one because we can't imply causation. There is a correlation, but that doesn't imply causation. So I'm liking the looks of this one, but let's keep going to be sure. There is a correlation between height and speed serve. However, there is no causation. This is because an increase and an increase. Well, it doesn't matter if it's positive, negative, whatever. We can't guarantee anything about causation. So this one is out. So it has to be number two. So remember, the key words on these types of problems is you cannot determine causation, okay? You can't say there is or isn't causation, but there may or may not be causation, okay? And that's about it.